In this video, I'll show you the benefit of using a polarizing filter, but first a little tour around Ribe, the oldest town in Denmark. Ribe is rich on history and culture, and I've wanted to photograph it and especially the cathedral for a long time. I really like how the cathedral stands out and towers above all the old houses. Since it has been quite a long time since Sophie and I had been on a photo tour together, we decided to spend a couple of days exploring the southern part of Denmark. On the day we arrived in Ribe, the weather was grey and wet and the light was flat and boring, so we went for a walk to explore the town, cathedral, the old houses, streets and green areas. I find there to be a very special atmosphere in Ribe, and it is of course down to the historical buildings. If you ever decide to come by Denmark, Ribe is worth the visit. As I said, my goal for the trip was to photograph the cathedral, and I really wanted a night photo of it lit by the street lights. Because of the technical difficulties of vlogging at night, I have no material from that, but the photo turned out really good and I'll show it later in the video. The next morning we waited for the clouds to evaporate and did manage to get a bit of the good light before the sun was too far above the horizon.
So we are in Ribe, and this is probably one of the most unsexy places I've ever taken a photo. Right now we're taking a photo of the cathedral and we're basically on a parking lot. But with the long lens, you can just crop out the church and it looks very beautiful. Obviously I've forgotten my polarizing filter, but I do have my big square polarizing filter for my wide angle, so I can just put that in front of the long lens and it all works. As you can see here, we are on top of a bench just to move the camera a little bit up as for get some of the street lights a little bit lower in the frame. There's not so much technical stuff about it. It's basically just aperture of f10, and with the polarizer on I get a shutter speed of 1/50th of a second. I overexposed it a little bit as to bring it down and theoretically get a cleaner image.
You can see here how the polarizer works in front of my DJI Osmo Pocket. It really brings out the blues and the colors of the scene. After we finished up at the parking lot, we went just outside the town to the field we visited the night before during the night shoot.
So it's really nice having a field just outside of the town because we can move back and zoom in so we can get that optical illusion where it looks as if the houses in front of the church or the cathedral are very small, because they are very small compared to the cathedral, but we actually do get to see how small they are. So you have this majestic cathedral coming out in the town. It just looks super, super nice. And again, I'm using the polarizing filter. So as you can see here, up behind me, the sun is here, and 90 degrees to the sun is the church, which means that the polarizing filter, polarizing effect works here because the light 90 degrees to the sun is polarized.
And that's the key to getting successful photos with a polarizing filter. Understanding that the polarized light in the atmosphere creates a 360 degrees band around the sky 90 degrees to the sun. Here you can really see how big of a difference the polarizing filter makes. It cuts through the haze and reveals the blue sky and clouds. In lack of better words, we get a much fresher photo where the side-lit cathedral stands out more. We also see the reflected light on the copper roof of the smaller tower being cut out. And that's because a lot of the reflected light in the scene is actually polarized. In this example from Lofoten, you can see how the glare on the wet surfaces are also polarized light. In this case, I used the polarizer to cut through that glare and reveal the round stone submerged in the small pool. If you've seen my 16-35mm videos, you might recall this scene from the Faroes. Here I also used a polarizer to darken the blues, making the clouds stand out even more. In this example, you can clearly see the band of polarized light being cut out whenever I turn the polarizing filter. The reason why you can see it is that I'm photographing with a wide-angle lens. And this goes to show how the polarizing effect is more pronounced with longer focal lengths, simply because the polarized part of the sky takes up more of the frame. In this example from Denmark, I used the long lens to photograph this tree during sunrise. When I turned the polarizing filter, the scene completely changed character. I'm not the one to say which is the best photo, but the difference is striking.
There's not much to my settings. Right now, I'm just in aperture priority. I am at f10, photographing first on the church and the houses. And then I'm also making one shot where my foreground is also in focus. I'm not sure if I'm going to blend them, focus stack those two pictures, but at least I have it. And that's what I always talk about. When you are in field, you collect data. And you can always decide when you come back home if you want to use it.
As I've got my drone certificate for doing commercial work such as this in towns in Denmark, I'm allowed to fly my drone within towns as long as I notify the police 24 hours ahead of flying and of course abide to the laws for flying a drone within a town, which comes with a lot of security rules. If you don't have a drone certificate, you need to be at least 50 meters from urban development, which you actually can at this location. A polarizing filter can also make a significant difference to your drone photos and video. I personally use case filters as they are of great quality and you can get almost any kind of type of filter for any lens or drone. This also includes the brand new magnetic filters. Check the link down in the description if you want to get a polarizer or any other filter. So this was my video on how I use a polarizer to bring out some freshness in the raw photos. I'll release an entire editing session of the last drone photo I showed in this video on Thursday. You cannot fake a polarizing effect in editing, but you can get reasonably close. In that editing video, I will, among a lot of other cool stuff, show how to do that. So thank you so much for watching. As always, I would highly appreciate both a like and a comment.